Welcome. Sea target, missiles, navigation, sextants, everything proves that we live on a globe. But flat earthers like Nathan Oakley thinks it proves a flat earth. First of all, I want to thank all my patrons, members, donors, and subscribers. All of you are important for me. Thank you very much. Lately, sextants have been a popular subject on different flat earth channels.
Point being, you need 90 degrees to the zenith position of the star, known as its geographical position or ground position.
Nathan tries to convince his audience that sextants only works on a flat earth. Flatzoid also makes an attempt to prove this statement.
To get the trigonometry to work, the horizontal has to be a 0 degree, aka flat plane. Thank you very much for watching.
I'm trained in navigation even with sextants, but I'm not going to make a video where I explain how it works. Because Conspiracy Cats have on his channel Baldy Cats made a brilliant video where he have Bob the Science Guy as a guest. I link to that video in the description. Anti-ship missiles. The one used by the ships in this video is RBS-15 from Saab, the Swedish company, and it's used by the Swedish, the Finnish, Polish, German, Thai and so on navies. This is the Swedish patrol ship Malmö. The boxes in the middle on the side of the boat contains RBS-15s. This is the Swedish corvette Visby, and it has RBS-15s, but they are hidden inside the ship. They open hatches to fire the missiles. The smaller ship here, together with Visby, is a Polish rescue and diving vessel. This is a Polish Orca class corvette, and in the back you see the box containing RBS-15s. This is a short presentation of the RBS-15. It can be carried by fighter jets, ships, or on trucks. I will explain why this is a great proof that we don't live on a flat pizza. How does the RBS 15 prove the globe? It's several things. One is the guiding systems. It uses GPS, active radar, and a inertial navigation system. That's a computer in the missile, and it has several sensors, accelerometer, gyro compass, and several other things. So, how does a gyro compass works on the flat Earth? Gravity is needed to make it work. And it uses GPS, which is a big problem for the Flat Earth fanatics, because they think space is fake and satellites are fake. How do the GPS system works if we don't have any satellite? And how can it hold this high precision it has if it's balloons and antennas and buoys giving the GPS signals? It don't work on the flat Earth. To avoid detection, the RBS 15 is flying very low over the surface. And why would it do that if the Earth was flat? Because the real reason is to avoid detections on radar. It uses the horizon to have it as a cover. But on a flat Earth, you would see the missiles on very long distances, even if it flying close to the surface. This is the target they hit in the video. And if you look at this image that from the video I took yesterday, you see one of those targets in the middle. So, do I know anything about this at all? Have a guess.
Radar.
In the Navy we use this radar system of different type. We're also sharing radar information between ships, and we also receive radar information from the coastal radar, such as the one on the mountain in the back here. And why do we do that? Because then we can see over the horizon. But on a flat Earth, you wouldn't need this. The radar has a horizon. That's a fact that's easy to prove. The horizon is further away than the visible horizon, and that's because microwaves behave differently in the atmosphere than visible light. The Visby Corvette I've shown in the video is built to not be seen on radar. On civilian boats and ships, you want to be seen on radar. For instance, on sailboats, they often place radar reflectors. And where do they place them? In the top of the mast, not at the hull. And why is that? Because depending on the horizon, the mast will be visible before the hull. It's so simple. Flat Earthers like Nathan Oakley, David Weiss, DRRTH, and Flatsoid FE thinks they know something about navigation. But the big question is, what qualification do they have? Brandon Toy, Jeremis, QE, Taboo Conspiracy, Kyle Adams all claims that they made a military service in the US Armed Forces. But what did they do their military service as? Sweeping hangars at an airbase or what? Because they haven't shown anything that they understand anything about radio, radars, and so on. In a few weeks I will drive a civilian boat full time, small fast boats with modern radar equipment. One of those are this boat. Since it's not military, I will be able to film on it. I will make videos where I prove that radar have a horizon and it's possible to calculate the horizon before I make the experiment. I'm 100% sure that no flat earthers can come up with the explanation for the horizon. Obviously, radar is a topic that flat earthers avoid. Or is there any flat earther that dares to make a proper video about radars and why they have a horizon? I'm looking forward to see that video and, of course, debunk it afterwards. In the next few weeks I will be quite busy with military work and preparing for a big television production. So I will not be able to put up so many videos. I have trouble with this English language. How can you speak this? Okay, as you all seen, I'm trying some different type of formats for my videos to make better content, to make better sound, video quality, but also to make them easy and quick to produce. So you're very welcome to comment below what you think's good or bad, if it's good as it is. Okay, that was all for this video. I hope you liked it. See you next time. Bye.